Welcome to The Math Planet, your fast math guide. Hello everyone! The title for today's lesson is Estimate Sums. Are you ready to start? Hi, I am Plessy. Do you remember me? Today we will learn how to estimate sums. In order to estimate the sum for this addition equation, we will do the following steps. First, we will estimate the first addend, then we will estimate the second addend, and finally we will add the two estimate numbers to get the estimate sum. Today we will learn two methods for estimating numbers. The first method is rounding. For rounding, you can use a number line, and if you use a number line, you need to determine three benchmarks, which are the lower benchmark, the upper benchmark, and the halfway number. If your number is closer to the lower benchmark, you round your number down to the lesser number. If your number is closer to the upper benchmark, you round your number up to the greater number. And if your number is exactly at the halfway number, you will also round your number up to the greater number. Another method for estimating numbers is to use compatible numbers. In addition, compatible numbers are pairs of numbers that are easy to add mentally, such as parts of 10. For example, if I know that 1 plus 9 equals 10, this will help me to add faster. Similarly, 10 plus 90 equals 100. Other examples are like 50 plus 50 equals 100, or 25 plus 75 equals 100. Notice that in rounding, if you use rounding, the rounded numbers often end with zero only, while compatible numbers do not necessarily end with zero. Now let's try to find the estimate sum using rounded numbers. Let's estimate the sum of 166 plus 158. First, I will round the first addend to the nearest 10, then I will round the second addend to the nearest 10, then the estimate sum will be the sum of the two rounded numbers. To round to the nearest 10, I will circle the tens digit in the first addend. The lower benchmark is 160 and the upper benchmark is 170. For the second addend, I will also circle the tens digit and determine the lower benchmark to be 150 and the upper benchmark is 160. Notice that the first addend is closer to the upper benchmark, so I will round it up to 170. The second addend is also closer to the upper benchmark, so I will round it up to 160. Then the estimate sum will be the sum of the two rounded numbers, so the estimate sum is 170 plus 160 equals 330. Let's solve one more example using rounding. Let's estimate the sum of 403 plus 179, but this time we will round to the nearest 100. So let's circle the hundreds digit in both addends. So I will circle the 4 and the 1. Next, I will determine my lower and upper benchmarks for each addend. So for 403, the lower benchmark is 400 and the upper benchmark is 500. For the second addend, the lower benchmark is 100 and the upper benchmark is 200. Notice that the first addend is closer to the lower benchmark, so I will round 403 to 400. The second addend is closer to the upper benchmark, so I will round it up to the upper benchmark. So I will round 179 to 200. Now the estimate sum can be found by adding the two rounded numbers. So the estimate sum will be 400 plus 200 equals 600. Now let's try to use compatible numbers to estimate sums. Let's try to estimate the sum of 112 plus 394. How we can do so? We need to think of pairs of numbers that are easy to add mentally. Let me think of 10 plus 90 equals 100. The first addend is 112. So I can estimate it to be 110. The second addend is 394. So I can estimate it to be 390. Then I can get the estimate sum to be 110 plus 390 equals 500. Let's try another example using compatible numbers. Use compatible numbers to estimate the sum of 170 plus 119. We need to think of pairs of numbers that are easy to add and that are close to my addends. So let me think of 75 plus 25 equals 100. 170 is close to 175, and 119 is close to 125. So my estimate sum can be 175 plus 125 equals 300. Hope you got it. To sum up today's lesson, today we learned how to estimate sums. In order to find the sum for this addition equation, we will estimate the first addend, then we will get an estimate number for the second addend, then we will add the two estimate numbers for the two addends to get the estimate sum. We can estimate the numbers using two methods. The first method is using rounding, the second method is using compatible numbers. This is the end of today's lesson. Thank you for watching. Hope you liked the video. Please press the like button if you liked the video, and don't forget to write your comment down below, and also don't forget to subscribe for more videos. See you later. Bye.